Okay, let's have a little look at some of the items that have arrived in the clinic for some future videos. First, we have this new torch here. Based on the design, we have good grip capability with the rubber finish also. A little strap there, on button here. Multiple bulbs there. This is going to provide us with excellent diffused light. So this should come in useful for any face or dermatology examinations, and particularly looking at the lids and lashes in some nice detail there. So that's item one, the new torch. Second item are these ocular lubricants. This is saline fresh. Active ingredient, carmelase 0.5%. Soothing and lubricating. They're preservative free and contact lens friendly. So this is the box. Have a little look. Come in mini strips, and here is one for you. That is the liquid, just confirming what it is there. And we have the expiry date there. To use, you twist the top and detach, and squeeze a drop into the desired eye. Over here we have a tube of Ketostix, checking for the presence of ketones in the urine. Let me just show you inside. There's your strips. Strip out. There we go. So this is the part that comes into contact with the urine. Fresh sample. As soon as it's been dipped in, you start counting, and after 15 seconds, compare the result to the colour on the scale there to determine the presence or level of presence of ketones, if any. We have some diagnostic ocular strips here. These are the Lissamine green. Pack of 100 strips. The directions there. The dates there. And this is a single strip from the box. So you peel there. Nothing should come into contact with the tip there. Place some saline on the end and just gently instill some against the conjunctiva. And this is going to help with diagnostic checking, because Lissamine green will bind to dead or devitalized cells in the eye. Over here, like every clinic should, we have a good supply of gloves. The these are Nitrile exam gloves, extra large for the big hands, 100 in the pack there. Very interesting item over here. This is a buzz hailer, which can be used by anybody with low vision. The instructions are here, but essentially you hold up the number of the buzz. You're looking to hail, like so. So let's say we're catching the C55. You present that to the bus driver by holding out. The bus driver will notice the number and stop for you. We have the braille there, selecting the correct character or numeral, and the green background means the bus driver shouldn't miss your hailer based on how this colour excites the visual system. Fresh pack of antibacterial wipes here, 12 in a pack, just ensure that you don't flush them. These are going to be particularly good for cleaning the slit lamp. Further information there. Pack of 50 lens cloths here, colour pink with the zigzag edges there, microfiber cloths, so excellent for spectacle cleaning. Let me introduce my new sunglasses. These are my super dryers. Very lightweight pair. Matte finish. The super dry logos here. I opted for a grey tint there. The size details there and the model colour, and the logo there. So these have been excellent so far for ultraviolet protection, glare reduction. Right, over here, I'm sure we can use this for some diabetic roleplay videos. We have a blood glucose checking device here. Okay, we have 50 pieces of strips. We have 50 blood lancets there. And there is the meter. Place the sample strip in and it will give us a reading of our blood glucose, something that lots of people could benefit from these days. There's from the back, further information there, how to store what's contained within. I have a little quick guide. just in the middle of the table here, we have a new chemistry set. Some cylinders here, some flasks and beakers in the background. We also have some pipettes. Three there, and a couple of stirrers. There. Now I feel these pieces are going to be very useful for creating a Breaking Bad roleplay video. And what I particularly enjoy about the cylinders are the sounds that are created when you remove the lid. Set. Different diameter cylinders there. Two measuring devices there and here. So I'm sure we can role play as Walt or Jesse with those. Right. Over here, one of my favourite additions to the clinic, an ultrasound spectacle cleaning bath. So if your spectacles have accumulated lots of muck and deposits, which can particularly happen against the pads, near the pads, between the metal frame and lens and within the joints, if there's any rubbish on your spectacles, essentially we fold them up, place them into the bath, and it's going to use the power of ultrasound to clean them. Vibrating sound is quite harsh, so I'll just press down, give you a little demonstration. 3 minute, 5 minute setting there. I believe we have constant there. Let's have a little look. Okay, when the desired time has elapsed, them out, you should have one clean pair of spectacles. You can just dry them and then polish the lenses. So that's the ultrasound cleaning bath. Okay, recently we did a nighttime reading session. Pleased to say that I found one of the books that I enjoyed very much in my childhood, the follow-up to Night Frights. We have more Night Frights here, so I'm sure we can read a couple of stories from this book for you. Author is J.B. Stamper. Of course, we have 13 stories. Show you the list of stories there, in case there's any particular ones you'd like me to read for you. The Vampire's Grave, The Hook, Two Dead Eyes, The Bloodsucker, Time is Running Out, Over the Hill, The Hitchhiker, The Blue Coffin, The Bogey, Night Creature, The Thing in the Back Seat, Night Bite, and The Red Bandana there. There's a little bit on the back for you, if you're interested. And we're on to the final item now. We have a near chart here. So at the top we have a 40 centimetre working distance tumbling E chart ranging from 660 to 66 equivalent distance vision. We have some music notes here. We have a map with some streets there. We have Shakespeare Way, Tennyson Way. We have some letters there at different points. Some print here with widening distance between the digits. And then we have the general reading chart here, ranging from N36 to N5. And from N18 onwards, we have a part at the bottom with just some random single words there. We have assume, once, fine, and some. So that's all the clinic items. Stay tuned, and I'm sure you'll be seeing them in some future videos.